This is Matt Russell, and welcome to the Daily FX Forum.
So here are the four pairs that I will be discussing this evening: the Euro Pound, the Aussie Kiwi, the Pound Swiss, and the Euro Swiss. So let's go ahead and pull up the charts. The first chart is the Euro Pound. If you recall, during the past several reports, I was calling for an A and this B wave top here. Prices never returned to the 92.14 area, but the long-term target for the ABC down is that 88.50 area, and progress towards that zone does continue. However, yes, during yesterday's video, I did mention a very short-term trade idea, and that trade idea did not work out. I personally did not enter on this, but I mentioned that we might look to enter here. Very aggressive traders might enter here with a 20 pip stop. So if that happened, you might have been stopped out by this wick here. So moving forward now, I just don't like this line. Again, it is short-term aggressive trading, and you're more likely to lose with those trades. So moving forward now, I would just sit on the sidelines and wait for the longer-term, more conservative setup near that 88.50 area. The next chart is the Aussie Kiwi, and during yesterday's report, I mentioned the breakout with the report, and then yesterday I was also mentioning how if this was a real breakout, I would like to take a little more risk in terms of trying to get into the trade, maybe 20 to 30 pips above the line here, above the previous resistance line, which might now act as support. And prices did come down. I believe this is 24.20, and I have this line right here at about 95, so that's roughly 25 pips. Personally, I did not enter on this trade, but you at home certainly might have. So if you are in this trade right now, I would continue to hold the trade right now and place your stop maybe about the 23. Keep your stop at that 23.50 area, which I mentioned last night. And again, if this breakout is for real, we could be heading much higher. And for, in my opinion, it's well worth the risk. But you always have to prepare yourself for the possibility that prices come straight down right now and hit your stop. And if you can't accept that, then maybe you should take some profits off the table at this time. The next chart is the Pound Swiss, and not much has changed here. The rally continues off the ugly, or messy if you will, bounce off the resistance, the former resistance line here, which turned into support. So right now it is getting a little, the rally is getting, I did mention to take profits half the position at this point here. If you're still in the trade, what I wanted to do is go ahead and remove this line and actually add a channel and see where this ends up here, and that would be connecting these lows here and then drawing a parallel line. Give me one moment here. Thank you for your patience. And once I do that and see where this line ends up, and it really depends exactly where you draw it, which price point you use, but I'm going to use the most conservative price point. So now for the remainder of the position right here, I might use this line here as a potential target, and that's at this moment a little bit above that 170 figure. So again, you at home, if you want to draw the parallel channel line, draw this line right here, and then again just select parallel line or duplicate line depending on your individual charting package, and then add it to the highs up here, and that can give you a target for this rally. But again, I did mention a few candles back to take at least half the position off the table. The next chart is the Euro Swiss, and not much has changed here. Still just waiting for this breakout. Obviously, with the central bank supposedly, you know, affecting price action here. Personally, I don't pay attention to any of that stuff. Mickey Mouse's birthday, news releases, it's all the same to me. But moving forward now, again, what I would mention is just be on the lookout for a severe breakout to this pattern. That's usually probably when the central bank capitulates. But again, I don't really care about any of those things. I'm just looking at the pure technicals at this moment, and it's coiling and it's in the apex, and something should give. Now, this is something that we can address certainly after the breakout, but if we do break out and prices kind of meander, then you know, something's going on that's beyond, you know, the realm of regular, if you will, technical analysis. But until that point, I'm still trading this as a viable triangle pattern. Again, my name is Matt Russell. Thank you for listening, and please stay tuned for a preview of the Daily FX Forums. I want to go ahead and formally welcome everybody to the Daily FX Forum. And I want to explain a little bit about the forum and the wealth of information that you can obtain from the forum, and how to go about doing so, how to find the things you want. So I'm just going to dive right in right now. And this is dailyfx.com. And this is usually how I navigate my way towards the forums. Obviously, you know, it really depends on each individual, how they access the forums. But this is how I go ahead and do it. I go to dailyfx.com, go ahead and click on the forum on top. And this brings you to the Daily FX Forum homepage. And this highlights the most recent posts with the subject. So if you see anything that you're interested in, you can obviously go ahead and click. What I like to do is click on the Forums tab like this, and go ahead and view the forums in the normal, typical way that forums are set up. And here you go, there are a bunch of threads down here. And I'm just going to go ahead and go directly to the forum, which the video you just viewed, where you viewed it. So let's go ahead. This is the Daily FX Instructor Tips Forum, Identifying Trades with Daily FX. That's me. And go ahead and click on the most recent post. So this is where you are right now viewing the video, although the video will be the video beneath this one that you're watching right now. So normally when I'm on the forums, and what I would do is just scroll up to the top. Certainly you can check out any of my previous videos, and you know, especially if I did mention them in the report or in the video that you're viewing at that moment. And what I will do is go ahead and click on the forums, and then look for the forums that I like, you know, that I have interest in. One of them would be the Euro Dollar forum. And this, again, it's really up to each individual trader as to exactly how they want to use the forum. Personally, what I like to do, the first thing I do is I'll go to the Euro Dollar thread. I'll go and click on the latest post. And what I'll do here is, and again, I just want to, you know, really emphasize this point. It depends on your exact mindset when you're viewing. And me as a trader, I have some experience. So what I do and how I personally use the forum is I go through and I'll read what people are saying about the euro, what their trade ideas are. I certainly, you know, try to maintain my own individual objectivity, and I really don't pay much attention to what other traders are saying in terms of my trading. I'm not going to certainly see something on a forum and then go jump into a trade. But what it will do, it will open my eyes to certain trading opportunities, maybe a certain line or a certain time frame that I haven't looked at before. So that's one way that I personally like to utilize the Daily FX forum. But certainly for newer traders, there are plenty of topics that you can go over. Let's say, you know, you might not be well versed in terms of certain currency pairs that you want to learn about. Scalping, you might not know what Elliott Wave is. You can go ahead and click there and see exactly what you can, you know, what you can understand, what you might not understand, and then certainly feel free to ask questions about any of these topics that you have. Maybe the carry trade, maybe you have some questions about that, or the sentiment, the SSI, or the latest economic news, FX programmers, the webinars, MT4, any questions about active trader, you can go ahead and click on those threads. So again, it's very free, very open, and there is a wealth of information here and just waiting for it to be utilized. Again, this is Matt Russell. Thank you for listening.